What's up guys, welcome to another video. Today we are going to compare the Lakme's Iconic Mascara with Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara. In this video, I'm going to give you a demo and show how each of them performs on your lashes, how they look on your lashes, compare their formulation, their wand applicator and also their price. So if you're interested in knowing then which one wins this battle and which one you should be basically paying your money for, then please keep on watching. The first difference that I want to talk about is their price point. The Maybelline one retails for 500 rupees and the Lakme one retails for 400. Price difference is not huge. Secondly, we are going to talk about their wand applicator. As you can see that the Maybelline applicator has well-defined, well-separated bristles for the upper and the lower lashes. The larger ones are for the upper lashes, whereas the smaller ones are for the lower lashes. The smaller bristles are the best thing about these applicator. It helps you do your lower lashes as well as the inner corners of your upper lashes flawlessly and without hurting your eyes. Also, you can see that every single bristle is very well-spaced and well-separated. That is, there is a proper gap between these bristles, which gives enough space for your lashes to fit in between and get coated evenly. It makes the application very smooth. The Lakme applicator on the other hand has only one type of bristle, which are large bristles for both upper and lower lashes. No separate bristles for the upper and the lower lashes, and it makes it very difficult to coat your lower lashes. Also, you can see that how clumsy and cluttered the bristles are, which makes it even more difficult, and they look almost like the spoolie brushes with which you can literally do your brows. Overall, not really a good option for doing your lashes. Next, I'm going to talk about their formulation. The Maybelline one is very smooth and creamy and does not clump up, and this mascara does give your lashes a lengthening and voluminous effect. As you can see, I'm using this one for the past 6 months and it has still not dried up. The Lakme one on the other hand is very clumpy and does not apply uniformly. The horrible spoolie applicator makes it even more difficult to do your upper lashes or any sort of lash. It does not give you any lengthening or voluminous effect, at least I have not noticed with this one. Plus, the formulation dries up really fast, like my bottle dried up within the first 3 months. One small tip here I would like to give you, that every time you purchase your mascara, always check their wand applicator. If it is too clumsy and there is only one type of bristles, which are large, and if they have spoolie kind of bristle, do not purchase them because they are not feasible for applying to the lashes. Look for bristles which are well spaced and well gapped, and they have smaller bristles as well, because you need to do your lower lashes. In my next video, I'm gonna be comparing the Plums Olive and Macadamia hair mask with Mama Earth's Argan hair mask. So if you're looking forward to that, then kindly take a moment to subscribe and tap the bell icon. If you like this video, then give it a big fat thumbs up, and also you can check out other videos from my channel. The last video I posted was my honest review about Masaba's Nykaa collaboration launch. If you want to check that video, I will link it in the I button as well as in the end screen. Till then, take care, stay gorgeous. I love you guys so much. I shall see you soon in my next video. Bye.